शील्डेड मेटल आर्क वेल्डिंग, देन टिग एंड सबमर्ज आर्क वेल्डिंग, दे आर इम्पोर्टेंट फ्रॉम एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. नाउ लेट अस सी व्हाट इज ब्रेजिंग. Generally, brazing is used for dissimilar metals, and the strength of the brazing is less than the strength of the welding. Brazing is also used for thin material, for joining of the thin material. Is the screen visible? Hello? Sir?
Yes, sir.
Screen is visible, no?
Yes, yes, sir.
Yeah. So, this is the base metal which is to be brazed. We have a torch here, and you have to deposit filler metal. Filler metal is usually in the form of a filler rod, and then you have to apply the flux. So generally what we do, we dip the filler rod in flux. There is a container, small dabba rehta hai flux ka. सो उसमें वो फिलर रॉड है वो डुबाते हैं हम लोग, एंड देन विद द हेल्प ऑफ द टॉर्च इट इज हीटेड एंड ब्रेजिंग इज कंप्लीटेड. रिमेंबर हियर यू आर नॉट मेल्टिंग द बेस मेटल. दैट इज व्हाट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर. यू आर नॉट मेल्टिंग द बेस मेटल, बट द फिलर मेटल is deposited in between two base metal, fine. So that it like our हम लोग जो gum use करते हैं gum, हाँ, so exactly like that. So how the gum holds two papers, so similarly that filler metal holds the two base metal. So this is the principle of your brazing as well as soldering also. Only difference is soldering is used for very thin material, and generally it is used in electronics for resistors, transistors, then your printed circuit board for that purpose. Your soldering is used, whereas brazing is used for your brazing of pipes, then joints, then couplings, etc. The temperatures in the brazing is in the range of 450, whereas for the soldering it is in the range of 250-300. The biggest advantage of brazing and soldering is dissimilar metals can be assembled. These are the filler metals, different filler metals that are used in brazing. Now have a look on this. So depending upon the base metal, you have to select the filler metal. So filler metal can be even gold also, because sometimes suppose you want to repair, suppose golden jewelry, suppose if it is broken off, then you need to repair it. So you take it to the shop, gold shop or goldsmith shop. So they do that brazing or soldering. So for that, the gold filler rods are used. So that's why even the repair of the gold jewelry is expensive. Why? Because gold filler rods are expensive. Even the gold is, because the gold is expensive. Almost 10 gram, that is, we call it the 1 tola, is around in the range of 45 to 50,000. So this is the graph of bracing joint strength against the clearance. So if the clearance is more, clearance means joint clearance. If the joint clearance is more, then the strength is less. So as the joint clearance goes on increasing, the strength, the tensile strength as well as the shear strength goes on decreasing. There are different ways of doing the brazing, the most popular being torch brazing. That is, we use a torch for brazing. Now the heat of the torch is used for melting the filler material. That is the purpose. We can also go for furnace brazing if it is mass production. If the number of components to be brazed are more, then we have to go for furnace brazing. So this is the filler material. The components are kept in the furnace, and this filler material, then it fills between the gap, and that's how the joint or the brazing takes place. This is again another example of brazing, that is induction brazing. So you have a coil here, and on the principle of EMI, that is electromagnetic induction, the heat is produced. That basic purpose of this furnace brazing or induction brazing is to generate the heat. Rest of the principle is same. That is, you are having filler material which is to be introduced or which is to be deposited between the joints, and you have to allow it to solidify. Okay, so depending upon the heating, the brazings are classified. That is, whether it is induction brazing or whether it is furnace brazing or torch brazing. So this is your torch brazing. We have to use a carburizing flame, that is also called as a reducing flame, in order to prevent the oxidation, because oxidation can reduce the strength of the joint. Another type is resistance brazing. So again, in resistance brazing, the heat, it all depends upon the heat, how you are producing the heat. So heat is obtained by resistance to the flow of electric current to the joint to be made. Okay. Then deep brazing. So deep brazing is again very simple. So again, here the heating of the joint is done by, we have to dip it, and that's why the name deep brazing. We have to dip the components along with the filler material which is introduced in the joint in a molten salt bath. Molten salt bath which is in the heated condition. Okay, so that is what is called the deep brazing. Then again, infrared brazing. So infrared brazing, so here to produce the heat, infrared lamps are used, and up to 5 kilowatt of heat energy can be developed. Then there is something we call the trade-off between brazing and welding. So that is what is called as the braze welding. So it is neither, you know, strong like a welding, or it is stronger than brazing, right? The material to be deposited is in between brazing and welding. So that's why it is called as the press welding. So like welding here, you have to prepare the joint, a small amount of a small V groove is cut inside the component, unlike your pure brazing. In pure brazing, you don't cut the groove, but in weld brazing, you have to cut the groove. That is, you have to prepare the joints. These are some guidelines for brazing for joint design. How to prepare the joints for brazing. Some more designs. Then good and poor or good and bad joints are shown in this example. Like here, too little joint area in shear. Then this is improved design when fatigue loading is a factor to be considered. That is, this design is better. Then this is insufficient bonding. So insufficient bonding or insufficient support. So here in this case, it's always advisable that you have a bore and then keep a component. What? Okay.
You inform HOD also.
HOD also. And you finish it before 3 o'clock. By 3 o'clock. Okay. Good, good. Then this is soldering, and as I said, soldering principle is same as that of the brazing. Only the temperature is in the range of 300 degrees Celsius, which is less than 450 degrees Celsius. Whereas for the brazing, it is in the range of 450. For the soldering, it is 300. For the welding, it is almost a melting point. So that is 1200-1300. In braze welding, it is in the range of 700-800. Again, you have solders here. So welds are used for thick plates, then brazing is used for still thinner plates or thinner component, and soldering is suitable for very thin components, and mostly it is used in semiconductor industries, that is in electronic industry. These are the solders and applications. So lead and tin is used for general purpose, are used as a general purpose solder. Zinc and tin is used for aluminium, lead and silver, and so on, cadmium silver. So wherever you see this silver, that is nothing but chandi. So that will be expensive solder. That filler rod will be expensive. It is in the range of around 15,000, 20,000 rupees per kg. And pure silver rods will be still expensive. So you have to use it very judiciously. Wave soldering is very famous or very popular in PCB soldering. So that is PCB soldering, printed circuit board, that is in electronic department. So what happens here, there is a wave of solder, like when you stand on the beach, so you get a wave. So similarly, there is a pull or wave of solder is passed on the entire PCB. First, you are familiar with the printed circuit board, so the tracks are cut. You know the tracks are cut as per the circuit. Then there are holes, and in the holes, the components are fitted, like resistor, bolo, transistor, capacitor. So they are all mounted. So all these electronic component, diode, resistor, transistors, capacitors, they are placed as per the circuit diagram. And then, and again, this is for the mounting. This is for the mounting. And then this printed circuit board is passed through the wave soldering machine. So where the wave of solder comes, okay, and soldering happens. Soldering happens wherever the joints are. So this is very useful for mass production, and this is also called as the SMT. SMT is nothing but surface mount technology. SMT is nothing but surface mount technology. So that is your wave soldering, and it is very, very popular in electronic industries, where the printed circuit boards has to be, you know, small printed circuit board, because there are many gadgets. You know, the demand for the electronic components, pen drive lelo, mobiles lelo, they are manufactured in plenty in mass production. So lots of printed circuit boards are required, thousands, lakhs of printed circuit. So no manual soldering is done. So it is all automated. It is all wave solder. So it is very fast. In a minute, the soldering is completed. This is the image of wave solder joint. So you get on surface mount. See, I was telling you SMT, that is surface mount technology, SMT. So this is an image of wave solder joint on surface mount device. Reflow soldering is not there in the syllabus, so you can very easily skip it. This is the joint design for the soldering, how the design should be. This is a difference between welding, brazing and soldering. So this you should do properly. So everything ready made I am giving you, because this can be asked. Difference between welding and brazing, difference between brazing and soldering, or difference between welding and soldering. So three permutations combination. And remember, differentiation, I told you, differentiation has to be written in tabular form only. Tabular form only. And if it is 2 marks, 2 points. If it is 5 marks, 5 points. Examples can be considered as 1 point of differentiation. Diagram can be considered as 1 point of differentiation. So if you are falling short, and differentiation is maximum for 5 marks. So if you are falling short, then you can use examples as 1 point. You can draw the diagram as another point. And definition, so that becomes your third point. And then 2 points you have to adjust here and there. Remember, both the points has to be correct, both the sides, left hand side and right hand side, then only you get a full mark. Even if one side is correct and another side is wrong, you don't get half mark, because it's a differentiation, both has to be correct. So here now, therefore, welding is the strongest, brazing is stronger than, and soldering is the weakest. Weakest, that doesn't mean कि आप ऐसे उसको पकड़ेंगे तो गिरेंगे, इतना तो उसको स्ट्रेंथ रहते हैं. इवन इफ यू पुल लिटिल बिट, इट विल नॉट, यू नो, द स्ट्रेंथ विल नॉट अफेक्ट, बट If you apply a large force, then definitely it will get disbanded. Temperatures, see here, soldering may it is less than 450. This is 450-500, and this is up to 3800. Sometimes when the arc is strike, that time it is around 4000-5000 degrees Celsius. So here, the workpiece to be joined has to be heated till their melting point. Here, only the filler material need to be melted. That's all. So we are not heating the workpieces in brazing and soldering. Remember. Now, because of this heating, material is heated and cooled. There is a cooling. So it's a kind of a heat treatment process, and so therefore your properties will change. The properties of the component will change, okay, because you are heating it, and that heating, because of the heating and cooling, there will be changes in the microstructure. And as I told, heat treatment is nothing but you have to change the microstructure, and if you change the microstructure, there will be difference. The properties will change. The properties will change, I said. And there are ways of heating, there are ways of cooling, there are ways of soaking, isn't it? Cooling, like suppose if you switch on one heater, if you switch on one heater, then heating will be slow. If you switch on two heaters, heating will be fast. Three heaters, heating will be still fast. So depending upon the temperature and depending upon the time, in how much time you want the temperature to achieve, we switch on the heaters. Then there is a blower in the furnace. So the purpose of blower is to make the heating, that is make the temperature over the entire furnace even or same. So at each and every corner of the furnace, the temperature should be same. So blowers are used, or the fans are used, to circulate the hot air inside the furnace so that the temperature is even. Otherwise, what will happen if there is no blower? Then near to the heater, the temperature will be more, and far away from the heater or in the center of the furnace, the temperature will be less. So we should avoid this condition. The temperature throughout the furnace should be uniform. So for that, blower or fans are very much important. So welding may sure the mechanical properties changes because heat treatment occurs. Then there will be a heat cost in welding. So you need a machine, isn't it? We have a inverter or we have a transformer for welding. So welding equipment cost is more, whereas brazing or soldering is. Soldering method, there is no cost at all. What you need is just a soldering gun, which is available for 100 rupees, and then filler rod. Okay, that's all. And flux ka dabbi. So soldering ka setup is 100-150 rupees. Whereas welding cost, the cost of the welding, depending upon the current and voltage, it can go till 1 lakh rupees or even more than that. So after welding, you have to do the stress relieving, okay, because the stresses are developed and you need to release or relieve those stresses, and that's why you have to do the operation of stress relieving. So heat treatment mein kaisa hai, there are different processes. So annealing bolo, tempering bolo, normalizing, these are all heat treatment processes depending upon the temperatures, depending upon the heating and cooling. Okay, so similarly, stress relieving is also a heat treatment process. So that's why we avoid welding, you know, that's why we go for the casting. See, now lay the bed. Why we prefer cast? Because casting has good damping characteristics and there are no stresses. At the same time, this lathe bed can be fabricated also using channels, I-beams, angles, plates, flats. You can construct a bed. You can construct a bed by welding. But then there are a lot of distortions and there will be a lot of stresses. So your entire welded structure will be stressed, will be stressed. And because of the stresses, what happens, what will happen during the service or during the use, this structure will fail. Okay. Now since, and this stress relieving is not required in brazing or in soldering. Then since in welding the temperatures are high, you need to preheat the component. Understand? आपको पहला प्री हीटिंग करना पड़ता है डायरेक्टली. आप कि मैं बोला ना कि जोर का धक्का धीरे से, वी डोंट गिव द बैड न्यूज इमिडिएटली इंस्टेंटली, स्लोली स्लोली देते हैं. तो सिमिलरली जो हीटिंग है दैट इज यू कैनॉट डायरेक्टली हीट 2000 डिग्री सेल्सियस में. कंपोनेंट जो है आपका फर्नेस 1000 डिग्री में हीट किया तो डायरेक्टली हम लोग उसमें डंप नहीं करते कंपोनेंट में. इट्स लाइक समथिंग लाइक आई टोल्ड यू दैट आप एकदम हीटेड एटमोसफेयर से आया और एसी एयर कंडीशन में घुस गए. योर बॉडी विल नॉट टॉलरेट दैट. अंडरस्टैंड? योर बॉडी विल नॉट टॉलरेट दैट. इवन हमारा घर में भी बोलते पेरेंट्स आने के बाद एकदम ठंडा चिल्ड वाटर, चिल्ड जूसेस यू आर नॉट सपोज टू टेक बिकॉज योर बॉडी इज ऑलरेडी एट 32 डिग्री सेल्सियस. एंड यू आर, वेन यू आर टेकिंग चिल्ड ड्रिंक और 15 डिग्री सेल्सियस, इट कैन डैमेज योर इंटेस्टिनल और योर डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम. तो सेम थिंग इज, वर्क पीस हैज टू बी प्री हीटेड डायरेक्टली. आप यू कैन नॉट एक्सपोज टू हायर टेम्परेचर्स. दीज आर द वेल्ड इफेक्ट्स. इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम एग्जामिनेशन पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, व्हाट आर द लिस्ट द डिफरेंट डिफेक्ट, वेल्डिंग डिफेक्ट, एंड एक्सप्लेन एनी थ्री और एक्सप्लेन एनी फोर. अंडर कटिंग, सो दिस इज वॉट इज अंडर कट. एंड सो द क्वेश्चन दैट एक्सप्लेन, इन एक्सप्लेनेशन यू हैव टू ड्रॉ द फिगर, वॉट इज द कॉज दैट यू हैव टू राइट, एंड वॉट इज द रेमेडी दैट ऑल्सो यू हैव टू राइट. तो फिगर सम एक्सप्लेनेशन इन टर्म्स ऑफ कॉज एंड रेमेडीज, जनरली यू गेट 2 मार्क्स पर डिफेक्ट. तो अंडरकटिंग यूजली इट इज रिजल्ट फ्रॉम द मेल्टिंग अवे ऑफ द बेस मेटल. सो यू गेट अ ग्रू काइंड ऑफ थिंग्स हियर. देन क्रैक, सो क्रैक्स कैन बी लॉन्जिट्यूडनल ट्रांसवर्स, देर कैन बी क्रेटर्स, अंडरबिट एंड टो क्रैक्स. These are the various factors, that is temperature gradients, variations in the compositions, porosity. Porosity is because of the entrapped gases. Gases are entrapped, so that's why porosity. So this is what see porosity, and it's because of the trapped gases. Lack of fusion. Lack of fusion matlab kya? The base metal and the pillar metal, they are not fused properly. So that's why there is no homogeneous, no homogeneity. Homogeneous matlab throughout the same. Like hum log vegetable mein namak dalte hai, so you have to stir it properly so that it becomes homogeneous. Nahi to kya hoga? Kahan pe aapko ekdam सॉल्टी लगेगा एंड कहाँ पे यू विल हैव टोटली नो सॉल्ट. इनकम्प्लीट पेनिट्रेशन. ओके, सो दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ, मेनली बिकॉज ऑफ द लो करंट और लार्जर आर्क लेंथ. ओके, सो रेमेडीज में क्या, वंस यू राइट द कॉजेस, रेमेडीज तो सिंपल है. Use like now, this is because of the low current. So remedies may use proper current or use adequate current. Ye ho gaya remedy. Okay. Then faulty weld size and the profile. So this is because of the preparation. Remember, for welding you need to prepare the joint. That is, you have to have a V joint or U joint or whatever it is properly. So there is something called the weld design. इसको हम लोग क्या बोलते हैं? well designed. So your well designed now is computerized. Manually it takes time. So well designed means what should be the depth, what should be the width of the V groove. Huh? So that comes under the weld design. Then you have how to test the welds, especially boilers. You know boilers where the purpose of boiler is to produce the steam. So here the water is heated. Now if any boiler you cannot manufacture, you have to go for welding. The center portion, that cylindrical shell, is rolled, and where it is rolled and where it is joined, so that has to be welded. Then you have two end shells, that is for the semispherical shells, or we also call the dish ends. So we prepare the dish ends, okay, under press. So press mein banate hain, and then two dish ends are joined to the center cylindrical shells, and then they are welded. Okay, that means any pressure vessel, you will definitely have minimum three welds at three places. You will have welding at three places minimum. Now, if this welding is not done properly, then there will be a leakage. And pressure vessels, what is the meaning of pressure vessels? Means it is vessel which is pressurized inside your fluid, which can be liquid or which can be gas, hot liquid or hot gas. So it is under pressure. So if there is a slight leak, it will come out like anything, you know, gas bolo or liquid bolo, it will come out like anything. And then it can cause the accident where the people are standing in front, that high pressure steam, high pressure, high temperature steam can pierce the people and can cause the death of the persons. So there are something called the destructive testing or non-destructive testing, NDT. There is a course on NDT, mostly graduate mechanical engineers, they do after B, 1 year course, because if you have B and NDT course, again you have level 1, level 2, then the chances for working abroad are very high immediately on the basis of this graduation and NDT course. So destructive mein kya hai, aapko components aapka kharab hoega, destructive matlab component will be broken, and in non destructive component will remain safe. Understand? So obviously everybody will go for NDT, non destructive testing, kyunki mera component remains intact, it's not going, I am not spoiling my component. So tension test. Now weld strength. So how to check the weld strength? So the component which are welded, they are subjected to tension. Okay, so usko khich ke dekhte how much load it can take, and you know this tension, shear strength, you know Hooke's law. Then bend test. Then component which are welded are bent either manually or with the help of a bending machine, and we are bending till it breaks. We are bending till it breaks. Okay, so that is what is your bend test. So how much load, bending load, it can take, so that can be confirmed. Similarly, fracture toughness test. So again, when the component is fractured, so that is what is your fracture toughness test. So this is all destructive testing. Okay, corrosion and creep test. So corrosion and creep will lead to the failure of the component. Okay, creep matlab what happens, as the temperature increases, the component goes on elongating, expanding. That is what is called the creep test. And since there are temperatures in welding, there are it has to be checked for the creep test. So this is what your bend test, B mein dikha hai, bend test. This is your tension test, your tension test. Then ye jo hai aapka C, so this is also a bending. Now once it is bent, Yeah, it's a clamp or a. Okay, now at the where they meet, so that has to be welded. Okay, and then this joint is tested. Then non-destructive testing may components are not broken. So your component remains safe. So in NDT, we have different methods like visual method, radiographic method, that is X-ray method, magnetic particle method, liquid penetrate, that is DP test, that is dye penetrating test, DP, and ultrasonic test. DP, that is dye, D for dye penetrant state. So these are the different NDT tests. And that 1 year course, you become master in all these tests, that is how to conduct this test, how to handle the equipments. Safety is very important in welding. So for that, you have to use helmet. Eye, do not observe welding arc with your naked eyes, other your eyes will get damaged. So observer as well as the welder, both should have the welding screen for eye protection. So using gloves, again gloves should conform to this standard, that is AS NZS 2161. Gloves conforming to this standard only, you have to purchase apron, respiratory protection, hearing protection. So welding without the protection may allow bare skin to be exposed to the welding arc. So this is for the welding gear. Welding gear matlab all safety devices. Okay. So you have hearing protection, you have cap, goggles, gloves, and then apron. Various gadgets. Ventilation is very important. Otherwise, a lot of suffocation happens because of the fumes. Okay, so that was your joining process. So you take a break and then we join around 10:15. All right. Hello. Harsh, Saif.
Yes.
Yeah, okay. Take a break of 10 minutes. We'll join around 10:15. Okay. Thank you. Yes. Are you back? Yes, Sheldon, how are you?
सर फाइन।
आवाज एकदम आपका वीक है।
सर वायरल फीवर,
सॉरी।
वायरल फीवर।
ओ हैव यू टेकन मेडिसिन्स?
यस यस।
ओके सो नाउ जॉइनिंग इज डन। डन में डाल देता हूँ। पॉलीमर मीन्स इट इज रिलेटेड टू योर प्लास्टिक्स। लेट्स गो फॉर पाउडर मेटलर्जी। So, as the name suggests, it is processing of the metallic powder. So, the basic requirement is metal should be available in powder condition. Means एमएस का प्लेट लीजिए और एमएस का फ्लैट लीजिए। सो दैट यू हैव या एमएस स्क्रैप यू हैव टू क्रश्ड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पाउडर। चिल्ड्रन इज द स्क्रीन विजिबल? हेलो इज द स्क्रीन विजिबल हर्ष?
यस सर, स्क्रीन इज विजिबल।
ओके सो एज लॉन्ग एज यू कैन क्रश द मेटल इनटू पाउडर फॉर्म यू कैन प्रोड्यूस द कंपोनेंट। एंड ऑल दिस मैन्युफैक्चरिंग प्रोसेसेस आर वेरी सिंपल। थियरी इज वेरी सिंपल अनलेस यू गो फॉर यू नो एनालिसिस। एनालिसिस मींस लाइक डेरिवेशंस। लाइक सपोज इफ यू टॉक अबाउट एक्सट्रूजन बोलो, रोलिंग बोलो, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू कैलकुलेट द फोर्सेस, एक्सट्रूजन फोर्सेस, रोलिंग फोर्सेस, डाई डिजाइन, इंजेक्शन फोर्सेस, सो दैट इज लिटिल डिफिकल्ट। बट इन द सेकेंड ईयर यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड वॉट इज प्रोसेस एंड देन ऑल दिस डिजाइन्स यू हैव इट इन थर्ड ईयर। So as long as you can crush the metal in powder form, you can make the components with the help of a die. Simple example I have given already, medicine, medicine ka powder. So you have powder available and that powder is compacted between lower punch and upper punch and a die. So exactly same principle, only here the powder is metallic powder. So obviously since it is metal, thing becomes difficult because the very first thing is that you have to crush. How to crush the metal? You have to crush the metal powder. That is the first thing. So you need a grinders, you need crushers, you need ball mixers for that. Second thing is you have to compact it. Now this is not, this is metallic powder, so this is not as soft as your medicine cup powders. So you need huge amount of forces to compact, to press it. So these are the two major factors, or you can say limitations in powder metallurgy. And moment you overcome this, then you have no limits, and then powder metallurgy becomes very economical if you solve these two problems, that is crushing and then compacting. So whatever you can machine from metal, like for example take gear or couplings, metallic gears or metallic couplings, if you have powder available and if you have pressing available, you can go for powder metal. So this is what is called as the powder metallurgy or powder manufacturing, and these are the scope, that is how to manufacture powder, what is the powder metallurgy process, what is sintering. Sintering is major step, and sintering is important from examination point of view. Then what are the different powder metal process, what are the products, etc., etc. So you have a metal, metal is crushed into powder, and then you get a metal product. So this is your metal product. I'll zoom a little bit. The components, what photographs, what you are seeing, they are done by the process of powder metallurgy. So you can make gears, cams, cranks, bearings, roller bearing cages, housings. So right from small to big. Various metals includes a pure metal or even an alloy. Alloy matlab, it is mixing of two or more different metals. That is what is called as the alloy. So if we begin, we have a scrap. Scrap is nothing but bhangar. Is a bhangar wala scrap jama karte hain and then take it to the foundry. Then there it is melted. Scrap is melted over there. Then this molten metal is solidified. This solid metal is then further crushed. This is a conventional way of producing powder. Now here in the diagram you can see you have molten metal . So under the pressure of gas, it is spread as shown in figure A. Molten metal is taken out through the siphon and then it is under the pressure of gas. It is spread inside a collection chamber and it is cooled in order to get the metal powder. So this is called as the atomization, atomization, that is you have a nozzle through which, a small nozzle through which the liquid metal or the molten metal is spread. Okay, and they are spread in such a way that while they get cooled, the metal powder is formed. This is your horizontal, this is your vertical method. So here gas is used for spraying the liquid metal, pressure of the gas, whereas here water is used. That is in diagram C. Diagram D, that is this. It is centrifugal atomization by the rotating disc method. So liquid metal is dropped on a rotating disc, and as it is rotating, due to centrifugal force, the metal is thrown outwards and then it gets condensed or solidified as a powder. Okay, so you have a scrap molten metal, say you have either a gas fired or a water fired liquid metal spray, which is collected in a collection chamber in order to get powders. There are several other ways of producing the powder. See, our first bottleneck or main hurdle is this, making powders. So now that is done. What are the other methods? Chemical reduction. Chemical reduction, that is removal of oxygen. Electrolytic deposition. Pulverization. Or grinding of bitter materials. This is how your powder are made. Then thermal decomposition, etc., etc. Condensation of metal vapors. The last slides you saw, that was condensation of metal vapors. These are the different shapes, particle shapes, which are possible. In powder metallurgy, you can have spongy, can have aggregated, cylindrical, cubic, rounded, lanky. As long as you have die, you have component. This, aapka die ban gaya, aapke paas powder hai, so you have to just press it. There is something called as the process of separating particle size. So you have to have a particular size of the particle in the powder. Okay, so for that It is passed through a mesh or a sieve. So it's a kind of a screening. So these are called the screened powder particles. And you can see that particles may be longer than the mesh. If you mix particles of different sizes, then what will happen? Like here now, say this is one side, so here you get a more amount of void or cavity. Here it is less, and here it is still less, because here you are using particles of different sizes, this is and this is, so your void become small and small. Actually, these voids are important because that makes the components porous. So it has a lubrication property. So that void is actually good. So this is a flow chart for powder metallurgy process. You have elemental or alloy metal powders, then your lubricants, then you blend it, then dye compacting, sintering. I have not told what it is. We'll see this now, one by one. So first you have powders, then in powder you add some binders, additives, blend करो, mix करो, mix करने के बाद dye में उसको लेके जाओ और dye में उसको press करो, sintering, in sintering we are heating it and soaking it so that it gains the strength. Then either you can go for successive manufacturing, whatever the operations are left, or you can directly go for finishing if all the manufacturing operations are done. And then after secondary finishing, you get a finished product. So blending is also called as a mixing. It's a combining of powder of the same material. There is a slight difference. Blending, it is material is same, and mixing, material is different. Tremendous amount of pressure is required to squeeze the powder into the desired shape. So this is what the component is, and you have a lower punch an upper punch. So initially when the upper punch is at the topmost position, the powder is fed, then you have upper punch, this is how a powder press will look like. It's a typical press, and generally it is hydraulic press. Now sintering may what we do, once the shape is formed, then we heat the powder below the melting point, and this here the powder is metallic powder, so heat the powder below the melting point to allow solid state diffusion and bond the particles together. So the movement of atom does happens in sintering because here in this process only sintering may only the diffusion and the bonding proper bonding takes place. See, look at this, how the sintering helps to bond. See here the clearances, gaps, and see final skeleton. So this is properly bonded. Here you have some temperatures, sintering temperature and sintering time. This is the graph of temperature against time. So initially it is at room temperature, then it is heated, then you achieve that furnace temperature, and then it is cooled down. So this is a typical heat treatment cycle in sintering. And sintering is done in a furnace, sintering furnace. So that sintering furnace will have different zones. Like you will have a baffle, then you will have preheating section, then sintering process being actually carried out and then cooling down. So preheating, main heating, sintering, and cooling is done in the same furnace, and that forms the cycle. These are the sintering production lines. So sintering is nothing but heating. आप heat करके वो product को so that there is a proper There is a good bonding. This is sintering product lines. Now, this is the strength of the centered structure against the density. So one is your fatigue strength and another is yield strength. So as the density increases from 6.65 to 7.15, your fatigue strength and yield strength also increases. What are the other powder metal processes? So you have cold isostatic processing, hot injection molding, powder rolling, extrusion, and plasma spin. So this is your isostatic processing. Have a look on this. I just come in a minute. So isostatic processing or isostatic pressing. So what it does, it uses pressurized fluid to compress the powder equally in all directions, and it is done in cold and in hot condition. So this is your cold isostatic processing or cold isostatic pressing. Figure number one. So what is happening in figure number one? This is a pressure vessel. This is a solid core pin, and you have a rubber mold. And then you have a powder here. Now you apply a pressurized fluid that goes from here. And since this is rubber, it gets pressed. And then powders are compacted. So this is what is your cold isostatic pressing. See, initially, अरे तुम बोलेगा अरे it look the same, but initially this is powder form. ये सब powder है. And now here it is compacted. And in hot isostatic pressing, it is done at high temperatures and higher pressures. This is an example of isostatic press. So iso means same, so same pressure is applied throughout, and static means it is in the steady condition. It's not dynamic, it's not moving. This is a injection molding process, which is same as your plastic injection molding, but this is meant for metallic powder. So here you have a feed hopper, okay, through which the metal is fed. This is screw and barrel assembly. Screw is rotating. Now this screw will push this material, that is metallic powder, and this is the cavity which is cut inside this die. Now this metallic powder flows. ये जो dot 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 दिखाया है, that is what your shape of the component is. And then we allow some cooling so that it is solidified. So remember, this is for the powder, but it is not common. It is not common. Injection molding is not common process for powder metallurgy. Powder metallurgy is done by compacting only, by compacting process only. Injection molding is a common process for your plastic. So first process was our isostatic pressing, second was injection molding, then third is powder rolling. So in powder rolling, powder is compressed in a rolling mill to form a strip. So this is a rolling mill, this is a powder. This is again a roll. So through which the powder is passed so that you get a strip, and this strip is called as a green strip or virgin strip because this is not treated, untreated. Now this green strip passes to the sintering furnace where it is heated. Yes, a heating fumes dikha hai, where it is heated. After heating, it is deformed, slight deformations or distortion occurs. So it is passed through the cold rolling mill, and then cold rolling mill will give the final shape and accuracy, and further it is again passed through the re-sintering furnace in order to get a finished strip. Next process is powder extrusion. So this is same like your extrusion process what we saw. So here powder can be extruded within a container. So this is a ramp, this is a powder, and then you have a die. So whatever shape is there inside the die, that is obtained. So you get a this. We have a die here, this is a powder. So round bar or round tube of metal powder is obtained. Again, remember, only isostatic pressing is commonly used for powder metallurgy. Injection molding, roll molding, powder extrusions, they need tremendous pressures. And if you want, if you have lot of pressures, then your setup, your equipment also need to be designed and manufactured to withstand such a high pressures. So the cost increases tremendously. Another method is plasma spraying. So here a plasma arc is used to direct the molten droplets. Now this is not a liquid. See, remember the difference between a molten liquid and molten droplet. Since it is atomized, it is always available in the form of droplets and not in the form of continuous liquid. That is the advantage of atomization. Atomization means as far as possible you try to get it in atom form. So it's not a continuous liquid, it's a droplet kind of thing. And obviously it will have high velocity and high density structure, and this is what is sprayed. This is what is sprayed, and this is spray, plasma spray. These are the advantages. The most powerful advantage is porosity or permeability, isn't it? So your product becomes self-lubricating. This is what is called as the self-lubricating. So you do not need any additional lubrication. So that becomes maintenance free. You don't have to lubricate frequently, or you don't have to fill the grease, you don't have to do greasing. It lubricates on its own because of the porosity. Any complex shapes can be produced. Many times we have components or material which are difficult to machine. So that can be produced to desired accuracy and tolerances with the help of this process. Another advantage, the strength of the product increases. There are some parameters or factors you need to consider in the design of the dies, while designing the dies. You have to think of ejection, that is how to remove the component. You have to also see that there are no thin walled or sharp corners, because thin walled sections may collapse due to high pressure. You cannot apply very high injection pressures. Again, the thin sections may collapse. Sharp corners are the stress risers. There should not be any abrupt changes in the sections. Abrupt changes. The changes should be smooth. From thicker to thinner, there should be gradual change. Like from 100 to 50 is dangerous, but 100 to 90, 90 to 80, 80 to 70, like that. Like you go to gym, on the first day itself, you don't try to, you know, lift 15 kg or 20 kg load. You go progressively, gradually. There are some shrinkages, like shrinkages what we saw in casting, which we get here in powder metallurgy also. So you need to design the dimensions or calculate the dimensions considering the shrinkages, and these shrinkages are available for a particular type of material. What are the shrinkages? They are available in the handbooks. So you can refer those literatures, and accordingly you can design the die. You need to avoid these undercuts and side holes. These undercuts you need to avoid, because that will cause problem in ejection. These are the various advantages. Biggest advantage is there is no scrap. Scrap can be totally eliminated or reduced. Only disadvantage is very high die cost and the material cost. So it can create part that could otherwise be difficult to form, and sintering will bond the particles properly. That is the biggest advantage of powder metallurgy. This is some notes I have on powder metallurgy. I'll just quickly go through this. This also I'll try to upload it. So So this is again self-explanatory. What are the limitations? What are the disadvantages? We have discussed all this. How to produce the metallic powder. Most important is atomization. I also told you what is the difference between atomization and liquid. This is gas atomization method which you saw. Then there is a water atomization also. So how the powders are produced by water. Can I continue for another hour? 11:15 ko main join kar raha hu. Join kar raha hu. Ha
11:15.
12 baje aap le sakte hain. Ha 12 baje. 12 baje meeting hai sir ke saath. Vishal sir ke
saath. Ha. Sir hame
aur Raut sir ke saath.
Sir
lekin kam ho gaya
15
minute thoda gas kar lo. 15 minute. Ha 15 minute. Ha 11:15. So these are the powders produced by the water atomization. This is what I have shown, conventional press and sintering step. That is, the metallic powder is pressed. This is exactly the same like what example I give in pharmaceutical industries for producing the medicinal tablets. And then this is sintered. So blending and mixing, I explained the difference. Mixing mein there are different chemistries. Compaction is nothing but pressing it. Sintering is nothing but heat treatment. The purpose is to have a good bonding so that this gap is reduced. This is a typical sintering cycle. So impregnation मतलब क्या? When oil or other fluid is permeated into the pores, मतलब हम लोग oil डालते हैं, so that throughout the life it becomes self lubricating. And infiltration means the pores of the powder metallurgy plant are filled with the molten metal. That is infiltration. These are the common powders, that is iron, aluminium, copper. Four classes of powder metallurgy plants, class 1, class 2. This is thicker, this is thin. Here there are two levels of thickness. This is one and this is another. So here sidewalls and undercuts can impose problem in ejecting. That's why you have to avoid, because then for this you need to provide cores, and then cores has to be first removed before you eject, before the component is to be removed. These are some guidelines for designing the component. Again, I have some note here, powder metallurgy process, how it is, how the metal powders are produced, what is atomization, what is chemical reduction process, what is electrolytic process, crushing process. This is most common, crushing followed by milling, condensation, then hydride. What is powder particle size? How it is distributed? What do you mean by compacting of powder? We all discussed sintering. These diagrams can be used for your answer papers. What are secondary operations? Applications of powder metallurgy. Biggest application is bearings and filters. Okay, we'll stop here and we'll meet tomorrow at 9 o'clock. Thank you very much. I will take the attendance. Just hold on. Shaunak?
Present, sir.
Present?
Yes, sir. Present, sir.
Yeah. Barbos?
Present, sir.
Bale Rao?
Present, sir.
Vedang? Danish? DiMelo, Sheldon?
Present, sir.
Elroy?
Present, sir.
Tyson? Saif is present, present. Mansi? Om?
Present, sir.
Present, sir.
Sheldon Lopez? Present, sir. Shannon Lopez?
Present, sir.
Neela Naik?
Present, sir.
Samiksha Naik? Panchal? Rodriguez?
Present, sir.
Again, Shannon Rodriguez?
Present, sir.
Rumao? Harsh is present. Archie?
Present, sir.
Okay, thank you. God bless you. See you tomorrow, 9 o'clock. Dot.